Well, good afternoon, everyone. The Ice Cube, one of a cluster of new venues inside the Olympic Park, just a few hundred yards from the Black Sea. And we now move inside it to witness the three sheets that are there appropriately placed for the gold medal and the bronze medal matches that will be coming up shortly. The traditions of Scotland, of course, are reenacted every time they come to play this sport. It goes back many hundred years, and the pipers and the drummers from Scotland announce the start of another big day of competition. They've already had round robin events. In fact, all nine matches were played. And in fact, we also had the semi-finals played, and we're now at the final stage for the gold, silver and bronze matches. The ice temperature -6 degrees, and you can see the pebbling on the top of the ice, which actually keeps the stones where they should be, riding high. It's the Russian Federation versus Canada in the gold medal match, but our concentration this time is on sheet B, where we will be having the bronze medal match. So the introduction of the players for the Great Britain team, and there was Angie Malone, followed by Jim Galt, Ewan, and Aileen Neilson is the skip, she's the fourth. And although it was a bit of a disaster in the semi-finals against Russia, they lost by 13 points to 4, they're hoping to make it up this afternoon, where they have a really good chance of picking up a medal. The Great Britain team have won 5 and lost 5 from their 10 matches played. And you can see of all of them they played against China in particular, they will be looking to overcome a deficit here. They are the team, and it was Zhu Huanjin, Chang Qian, Liu Wei, the vice skipper, and Wang Haitao is the skipper, a left-hander, 24 years old. Their expectations are really, really high. There you go. Oh, that is an interesting variation on the theme, I have to say. We haven't seen that before. There, again, they're really, really well matched. They beat Great Britain 6-3. In an earlier encounter, so they will have certainly the favorite status, I would think, in this particular match. They are very much the thinkers of the whole tournament. They treat it like chess, and of course the Chinese are traditionally very good at the game of chess. They are much younger than their counterparts, 24, actually 23 being the youngest. The lead off is Zhu Huanjin. Looks like Angie is going to start. It is Angie Malone, lead for Great Britain. One more match to go. The excitement is there. 68 minutes, you can see it in the back, and of course all those union flags will be very encouraging above sheet B. Well, if you haven't seen wheelchair curling before, you can see that the chair itself is placed inside a little channel of lines. And the stick is now atop the handle of the stone as it's released. Angie Malone, it's 71% accuracy, that's pretty good. And it's an in-turning block, so if you have a look over the top, it's going clockwise, coming down towards the center line. That will come into the house, and it'll come to the button, and it will just go past the button into the forefoot. A solid first stone there from Angie Malone for Great Britain.
Is that the number one? doing that.
I think they already we've seen a change of tactics from the previous match. And here we have now Zhu Chuanqin, 23-year-old. And as we're going to see an attempt to take out here, are we? It's going to go to where it belongs, and there it has been taken out. Hit and roll there, rolling into the 8 foot. Just in case you haven't noticed the difference, of course, there are no sweepers in this particular discipline. The wheelchair curling, no sweepers at all. And you can see that the handle has
front of the left
a stick on the top of it.
Front. Left a wee bit yet.
And Angie Malone with her second.
Ready, Jim?
China has the hammer. They have got the final stone in this end. Best of eight ends. A good reach forward there by Angie Malone. Is she also going to try to take the take and roll? A hit and roll here. It's going an out turning. And it's going certainly towards. Yeah, good work. Yeah, takes out the Chinese stone and puts her own in the back part of the eighth. The white.
Is doing the bag of fine now, or is that in a danger stone?
They've still got their hammer.
Well, they would have been really disappointed losing 7 points in end four. Great Britain. Been much more consistency from China. In fact, they only lost by one to Canada in the semi-final. Again, a lot of power created. Good play here from Zhu Chuanqin. She takes it. Nicely played, right on the nose there. Stays on in eight, and that is a good result there for China at the moment after four stones. The nearest to the centre at the end of the end is picking up at least 1 point, perhaps two. And in that case with Russia, picked up seven. Seven points in one end. Quite disastrous for Great Britain. Jim Galt, he's a late replacement, in fact, and well, he's played pretty well, I have to say. Again, it's an out-turning shot coming in towards. Is it just missed its target? Oh, just taken the target, but it's not quite enough to do damage. There was a lot of extra bit of curl on that. And the 59-year-old Jim Galt has replaced Tom Killen. We hope that Tom is well, if he's listening. And he had to be replacement for illness. A hugely experienced curler. Right, coming in now.
Zhang Qian,
another right-hander. The most experienced curler, 34 years old. So 50% accuracy. That's not so great. He's looking around a bit anxious here. And again, it's an out-turning curl coming in towards the target. And he's gone through. A bit heavy there. And I thought with the hammer that China would have been keen to try and get as many into the house as possible right here.
This would be a nine.
And a nine means, well, in fact we call it one through nine. One at the front, nine is at the back. So this has got to be fairly heavy, but it's got to be accurate. Jim Galt again.
Mine's good.
In perfect position, the chair is being held back to counter that push forward, focusing hard on this one, and he needs to make contact and get rid of that stone that's causing a few problems at the back of the house, and he just does it and takes his own out as well.
Good,
only just. Oof, too tight.
Think it's out. Huh?
It just is out. We're wide. Looking over the top now of the centre.
Oh, bomb and a brush there that time. Yeah. Okay. Just give the
It's very interesting. I know that we are broadcasting to the world, and there will be many people who will say, well, I thought they were speaking English. Well, it's a Scottish English, and it's very difficult to understand for many people. But you will pick up their accent, I'm sure, and there'll certainly be words that you'll be able to understand. Maybe not so much Mandarin. Well, he missed it last time. He went through the house. Let's see what he does this time. It's a little bit better weight here. Just coming up towards the house. He's in the house now. And he's coming through again a little bit. Well, he's gone below the T line there, which is the halfway line. It's still in the 8 foot. A little bit nervous to start with by Chang Qian. Here, there's a lot of support for the home nation, Russia, playing on adjacent sheet. Now, Gregor Ewan fires one in, and it's only got 50% accuracy. We'll be looking for a little bit better than that here, but it looks like he's going to make contact. That's better. He wants it on the nose if he can. He's got it. Good work. But with that stone just on the outside of the house, it's aided China to stay on the board. It's nay bad. You heard that. Well, that means it's not bad. It's good. The skip there showing where he wants the aim to be. Here's the target. Long handle here. Long handle. It's going to be, again, a takeout. Straight down through. And I think he's happy with that. How how. Yes, how how. It's got it right on the nose here. Coming up. It's a beauty. Well played. Not only did he take out the opponent's stone, he kept his own in play. Excellent. Again, a 9 is called for from Aileen Neilson. Gregor Ewan, he's under a bit of pressure here. He's got to take this one out. And if he gets the right angle on it, of course, keeps his own there, and he could be taking a double takeout here. That's the ambition. What's the line? Is he happy? The same with those shades. Do you like it?
Unlucky, dude.
Oh, he's missed it.
Good weight, Gregor.
The weight was good, but the accuracy was not at all good.
Holy mackerel, man.
Well, that's an early setback there for Gregor Ewan. The Chinese can now put the pressure on here, stacking the house. Liu Wei now, the vice captain. The crescendo of noise is coming from the Russian host crowd, getting very excited at this early start of the gold and the silver and bronze medal matches. This will come just nice and easily into the house. Up to the 4 foot is the ambition. Just on the edge of the 4 foot. That's excellent. Now, that's so split, it's going to be very difficult here for Aileen Neilson to take rid of, well, she certainly won't get rid of both of them.
Yeah, leave it more, Gregor.
Yeah, good work. So it'll be left now to Wang Haitao.
Same line as Gregor, full 18.
Come on, baby.
They do enjoy themselves, don't they? Come on, baby. This mixed sport. Wheelchair curling is coming to a crescendo this afternoon. 62 minutes on the clock. 6 minutes gone after this period of 12 stones being played. Here we go. That really needs to be accurate. She's struggled a little bit earlier. Oh, look at this. Oh, she's saying, and she missed it. Oh, please. This is going to be difficult. She has missed it. Oh dear.
Good try, Aileen.
You can't afford to be that inaccurate. And it's now going to pile on the pressure. The Chinese are going to come in with two more. And look how close it was, but it wasn't good enough. The curl was the in-turning curl. She needed to have it more than that. This is going to be very difficult for Great Britain to get back into this. They're stacking up. I called them the sunflowers, the yellow tops. The whole area around Krasnodar is full of sunflowers in the season. Now, you probably noticed and realized that the captain, Wang Haitao, is a lefty, a left-hander, so the curl will come in a different direction. It will be an outturn if it's going from left back to right. What have we got here? Let's have a look at it. It's going to pile on the pressure inside the house. And that is a very nice shot. That is very good. Now, this is going to be so difficult for Aileen Neilson. She needs huge accuracy here. What is she going to try?
More, Gregor. Used to be edge of the four.
If she misses this one, she could go really, really into a very difficult... Already they're sitting 4 points at the moment, China. The first end, I know they've got the last rock. But
just need to try and freeze onto that one. Yeah.
That's what we thought.
So an early, real notice of intention here by the Chinese. This is a huge pressure shot from Aileen Neilson. At the end of the first end, she needs to get this one accurate. The ideal would be an attempted clear out here, but does she have the power to do that? It's so, so much more difficult. It's a medium length stick that she's using. There's not a lot of whip and power in it. Let's see what her arm has managed to achieve here. It's almost there. But it's certainly not going to clear that out. It's going to just go in. It's a draw into the towards the center, and in fact it will be an interesting shot here. But she's played a raise up against that rock on the right. China sitting one at the moment. I think they're reasonably happy that they've staunch the blood at the moment in Great Britain, but there's a chance here for China to start with a huge score. Wang Haitao will go back and try to clear out that redstone, keep the other three in play and leave the fourth, so you can be looking at 4 points here. Four, perhaps even five. Unusual to see the athlete clean his own stone, but obviously pretty confident here. Right, this is a big end for both these teams. The start of the bronze medal match, the end of the first end, and he's got a chance to take out not only the Great Britain stone, but then put four or five in its place. What has he got? Oh, he's missed it. He's missed it. And that is just 1 point to China. Oh, that really was a great break. 1 point to China. And Great Britain have escaped there. Wow. Wow. You cannot believe that. That really is a huge stroke of luck for Great Britain and for Aileen Neilson. And after that,
we
got out of that. You heard what she said.
We're going for her two. Okay. Just shout up, Jim, if that's okay. It's okay. We're going for her two.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. You heard what Aileen Neilson said there. We got out of that. We escaped from jail with that one. No doubt at all. It was obvious for all to see. But now she's going for two. She's got the hammer, which means that they have now the last stone. Well, that could have been a disastrous start, but Great Britain escaped there. They've got to now try to dominate rather than be hanging in and hanging on. So, here's the first shot, the second end. Zhu Chuanjin. Now, is she going to go for the house or going to set up a guard? It's going to be interesting here. It's an in-turner, and it's certainly got weight on this one. It looks like a draw weight to the house, and it is coming in all the way past the eight, into the four, and just on the edge of the button. Good work. Zhu Chuanjin from Heilongjiang province. Chitahe, she's now residing. And the third in Korea in 2012 in the World Championships. Third team in Russia 2013. So he could be third here. That's the ambition. They want the bronze. Here's Angie Malone. She's going to drop one in quite short. Yeah, she's dropping a guard in there, corner guard, midway.
Steered it a wee bit.
Yeah. And she says, I steered it a little bit far out, but it can still have its effect there. It's not a major problem. So, declined the invitation to come and take out the stone in the centre, so that gives the option here for Zhu Chuanjin. She can either play another one into the house, or play a short guard. Asking to have it cleaned. There you go. It's very interesting, because there are no sweepers, of course, it's all about the weight at the start. And sometimes there is a little bit of hold on the ice. It's a much longer handle of stick, isn't it, that she's using in the British team. So again, another in-turner. It'll come from left to right as she sees it on its way in towards. The center is just going to go past that tee line and maybe a little bit disappointing. In fact, way past into deep. Chance here if they get it absolutely right for Angie Malone. If she wants to go, take out the...
Take it away, honey. Take it away.
Right to the center. Go towards the button. Take out and maybe have a double take out. You never know. Let's have a look.
That looks good, Ange.
She needs to be just to the right of center of that first stone.
Okay, Ange.
Hold me tight, Jim, she says. And it is an attempt at take out here. She's setting it on his way, but has it got the direction? There's the question, is it got the direction? She needs to be right of that center stone. She's got it just about right there. And that is a good effort. It's certainly replaced the point counting stone at the moment. To Great Britain. It's a double hit. She promoted that Chinese stone, took it out from counting. Three draws to Angie Malone then, and that's 92%. So, Chang Jian. Again, it's going to be in from right to left. And oh, he's just missed it. And that really is another big break for Great Britain. He's made a couple of errors here. Zhang Jian, a little bit of pressure on. The attempted takeout there was no good. So, Jim Galt now. And see what he can do about perhaps not sure. I think he's going to leave it short. It sounds like it. 3-4 suggests he's going to be just at the top of the house. maybe just into the 12-foot mark, the blue circle. Looking at it pretty well, and yeah, it is. Again, it's an interner coming just to the top of the house. It just stretched. There you go. That's nice work. Quite close to his partner, and in fact, it's not. I mean, China have got second stone there, so.
He's one to the back, but it's
on the nose.
And if we can see his, and it's not going to get
They're all mic'd up, of course, so you can hear conversations all around the place. You've got the vice captain, Gregor Yuen, talking with Aileen Neilson, and then there's Jim Gold at the other talking to Malone. So there's a lot of conversation going on. This is an important one now for Zhang Jian. He missed the shot previously. Great Britain hoping to be able... There's the in-turning shot. There it is. It's going clockwise around, so it will make its target this time. Yep. And he's done really well, taking out one completely. And leaving one on the edge, although it's still holding China point. Yeah, he was a little bit disappointed. He's not got the second point for China. So this is now Jim Galt's going for a double takeout here for sure.
4-5.
4-5.
Yep.
Repeat of the weight. That's the ambition, Jim Galt. He needs the direction here.
Right, all the way up, is this?
Yeah.
It's all about direction. There's no sweeping to make any difference. And that will come in handily in towards the center, and that will just about hold, will it? Yep, he's just about got first stone there.
Good one, Jim. Beautiful.
Yeah. So he gets congratulations from. Well, this is going to be a hit and roll attempt, I think. Liu Wei, the vice captain. 29 years old, again from Heilongjiang. Looks at it right down the barrel of that stick. It needs to just be a little bit to the right of the head of this one. Oh, and he's gone the other way, but that's okay. It's really difficult to know what he had intended there. It probably would have been better if he'd gone on the other side of the stone and then kicked in towards the center. But no, they're quite happy with that. Do you remember what Aileen said a couple of moments ago? We're going to aim for getting two here. But they're not in great position at the moment, are they? So the vice skip, Gregor Yuen. He doesn't waste any time, does he? Gets it dispatched very quickly. And there's been a confident, that looks good, Ewan, from behind him. Let's see whether or not the yellows will think the same. And it's gone through just a little bit, yeah. Nicely held, just in front of the tee line there.
Well, umpires tell you to stay in the red box. That's what they told us yesterday. We've been in the red box all the time. Red box here, red box, same as morning.
Hey guys, what box you want to sit in? Do you want to sit in this box or that one over there?
The conversation, the subject of which talking about the little red box. Well, there's red and white and blue circles there that they're aiming for. This is another shot here from Liu Wei. Not forgetting, okay, there's another takeout shot attempt here, and it is good. Yeah, beautiful. Now that's the one that I thought he was going to play first time. And he's now got a very, very good position. It looks interesting here. Although there are more yellows, than
three,
red.
5-6.
Aileen Neilson won't be too upset at the moment. Gregor Ewan again, concentrating. He's a little bit on the angle, isn't he, with his wheelchair. At least he's got his wheel inside the corridor that he must at least be in contact with. Is that good enough to make a difference here? Is he just pulling a draw in? And it's not quite enough.
It was
gee whiz.
Too much ice again.
When he says too much ice, he means he started out too far to the left. This is going to be very interesting now because they've got three in a row. It's going to be difficult to get those out the way. I think the best that Aileen Neilson could look for here is a one at the moment.
Okay.
So, coming to the business end of this end, it's the first shot to 155. And it looks like he might be attacking the stone that's in the white circle, in the 8-foot circle. And the left-hander could easily come in from that side, so it, for him, it's going to be an out turner. Again, very, very long stick. Great accuracy, and you can see just to the right the stopwatch has started. It's all very important, this timekeeping. There you go. So, has he managed to achieve the ambition here? On its way into the circle, it's gone past 8 foot and it's there. Look at them, four in a row. As it stands, sits at the moment, it looks like China with two, but there's two stones left for Aileen Neilson from Great Britain to do something about this. Talking numbers, middle of the 12, that is the 12 foot, that's the red circle she's been talking about there.
Just try and draw it onto the button, but there's also the back one to draw on it.
Draw it to the button, yeah, well in fact, she's not quite got a good position for the...
Come on, Ellie.
The 2 points that she's hoping to get here. I don't know. It's going to be a tough one, this. She's got two stones to try and make something of it. Angie Malone holding on tight here as this one fires away. Has she got the accuracy? Looking a little bit apprehensive, I have to say. There's not celebration there, is there? It's coming up from wide out here on the... The intern shot is going for the button, but it's not going to be there. It's not going to be there, and this could be a big, big end. It could be a big end for China because they're all exposed. That is not good for Great Britain. They've still got one more rock to go, but they can get rid of those two, both of them. Yeah, there's the discussion. Right side of that lead stone. And they get rid of two. I don't know why it is, but from what I've observed, Aileen Neilson just doesn't like the idea of takeout. She plays draws most of the time. She's left the Chinese here with a really good opportunity. He's a strong boy, and he can certainly do damage here. They're too close to the center button to be taken for granted here, and it was a disastrous fourth end against Russia. They lost 7 points to Great Britain in the semi-final. Not going to be a repeat of that, is it? Last stone then for Wang Haitao, and he's fired one in here. Has he got the accuracy? Is it there? It needs to be touching that lead red stone. Has it got it? It has. It's a great effort. Now, this is going to be crucial for Great Britain. There's no room for other than huge accuracy here for Aileen Neilson. This is big pressure. How, well done, good. Teammate Liu Wei.
Aileen.
Well, there are not too many options here. Aileen Neilson has got to get that close to the button. She's got to get really in close here.
Nice wee nest, Aileen.
It's going to be an in-turner. I believe that's her natural way. And she's got to get it close to the button. Now, the ideal would be to take the one that's already touching the button and then replace her own stone with it. Is she going to come in the other side? This is the last stone. Aileen Neilson concentrating, sets it on its way. It's got a lot of opposition there. There are loads of yellow stones there in the way. It is coming in the other way. It's coming in out-turning movement in towards, and it's just gone a little bit too far, is it? Oh, it has, and that is going to be two. It's a steal of two. Three yellow? No, is it? I think it's two yellow. Anyway, there's a steal there to China.
Go for the steal.
Let's have a look. Yeah, that's really not good. Yeah, it was a two. So that's 3-0 in favor of China. They have stolen. The only problem is there, Great Britain have still got the hammer, of course. They got the last stone to come, but that was not great play. They allowed it to develop and the pressure built up on the Great Britain team because China were allowed to stack the house. There's the score after two ends. China maintaining that momentum. Great Britain escaped after the first one, but there's only so much pressure you can keep taking. And there is huge pressure on the skip, Aileen Neilson. Not just for accuracy, of course. But she needs the strength as well. Li Ning on the top there was a very, very famous Chinese gymnast. Who was a great hero in China. One of the first to break into the big world of sporting accomplishment. It's gone through, isn't it? I think it
has.
Wow. There's no lack of strength there, was there? Not sure that was meant. Very difficult to know what's going on in the minds of these players, though. Sometimes to blank is a strategy. I don't think that. Well, as I said, the only thing here going for Great Britain is that they do have the hammer. The last stone. Angie Malone puts one down. It will be quite a long guard. Yeah. In fact, it's short guard when it comes to the house, but that strategy has worked in the past, pushing it out wide. You might be able to hide behind that guard stone. Wang Haitao really is a student of strategy. Now, what are we going to see this time from Cool Planking? Certainly not going to go through, is it?
Shana!
No, that's better.
Ole!
hold its place on the forefoot. Very good. Yep, happy with that. So, we need to make use of that guard at some stage, but right now, they can't leave these yellow stones to do damage.
4-5 inch.
Look at the difference in height of the sticks. Wang Haitao, he's got a really high stick behind. This one is just a little more than half that length. Angie Malone sets it on its way. Are you happy, Angie? So again, it's coming out to that side. She's going to tuck it in behind her lead stone. Very nice. That's very good. Nicely played. Very good. See the strategy there. She sets out the first guard. The second one, she tucks it in behind. Difficult to get to. Maybe just showing a little bit. It's a good effort.
Sets up for two.
We need to appreciate why they're not taking out low. I know that's a defensive position and they're trying to attack, but the more the yellow stones are there, the more potentially inaccurate, or more accurate you have to be, and the potential for risk is there. So this is Zhang Jiang. He missed his first takeout attempt. Let's see what he does here. It's certainly a good effort. He's coming close. Ooh. Well, all he's managed to do is to move a little sideways, that guard. It wasn't on the nose. But he's exposed now. The GBR shot was in. And you heard the nose, you could see. Wants it right on the nose there and leave it in its place. So you can see it's the right shoulder. Maybe you can interpret. If you can't understand Scottish English, you know that she says, right, we want this on the right shoulder. And then put it on the nose and leave your own there, Jim. Come on. That's what she's saying. Leave your own there into the blue, as he actually got it right there where it counts. It is close. It's not quite on the nose. Needed it. Yeah. It wasn't tight enough to the center. Only half the job done there. Getting rid of the opposition was one thing, but then leaving the other one in your place would have been the ideal. So, Zhang Jiang did a half a job last time as well. So let's see whether or not he can remove. I think that's the ambition here. The Chinese, certainly their strategy is to take out. They've got a three lead at the minute, a 3-point lead, so they can defend this. It's certainly going, not moving much, is it? There you go, excellent play. There wasn't much curl on that, that was straight. Good work, very nicely played, into the forefoot. China holding one. Good work there from Zhang Jiang. They need to be a little bit more aggressive for me, Aileen Neilson.
Mine's good, Jim.
Just got a strategy.
Good.
Lifting up, getting a bit more aggressive. So Jim Gok sends his delivery out. And this one needs to be on the nose and replacing the one that's there. That's a bit better.
Nice one.
That's a bit better.
Boys and girls.
So skip, Wang Haitao points the brush. He wants a little bit to the left. The head of the stone, and that is pushed out by Liu Wei. It's difficult to know whether he's happy with that. Is that going to miss? It is. Wow. That really was. From the word go, you could tell that it was curling too much for him, and that is a miss here. Now, Great Britain could. Yeah. Big puff of cheeks here. Pressure, maybe? We can get another couple in. A score of two here would make a big difference to their confidence. By skip, Gregor Ewan now preparing. Takes a long look at it. What's he got? Again, without the sweepers, of course, once you've released. He's trying to get it, curl it in behind the... In fact, he's just got it there as an extra guard, but maybe it will come to their rescue eventually. There's only three more stones, of course, for Great Britain to use, but I think he could have possibly been a little bit closer to the centre. It's going to be a takeout this time, you watch. And he's going to, Liu Wei is going to leave the yellow one right on the blue here. He takes the in-turning curl. So it'll go from left to right. And he's got it this time absolutely on the nail. There you go. And he might even, well, I was just going to say, he could actually use the red guard as well. He didn't use that quite.
Step back, 6-7.
So the brush has been transferred to Liu Wei. Wang Haitao will be coming up. And in the meantime, it's Gregor Ewan. No takeouts. Four draws now. This time, yeah, looking good, he says. Just coming out and... it's not enough. Should have been on the nose.
See what they do now.
Still in there.
Mm-hmm. And you've big problem, of course, when you don't have sweeping, shouting at the stone. Once you've released it, it's entirely on its own. There's nothing you can do about it. So, a couple of stones left for Wang Haitao. Five victories and five defeats each. Very, very well matched. China qualified in second place in the World Championship points in 2011, 2012, 2013. So Russia were in third place now. This is an important, very, very important shot. Is it going too fast, too hard, too straight? Oh, and that really is a big bonus. A big bonus for the Great Britain team. China's still holding shot there, but we'll see for how long.
I gave you that, didn't I? 6-7, parallel.
You're going parallel to this?
Yeah.
6-7?
Yeah.
6-7 is the weight. The 6-7 is actually on the button, so.
Come on, Ellie.
This
the
is another.
6-7, just try to give that a wee.
Did you see that? Yeah, just going to get a wee bump. Okay. Okay, come on, Ellie.
You can hear Jim Cox's voice there in the background. Come on, Ellie. 10 matches already played. This is the 11th.
Mine's
this is
good.
The glory match. This is for the podium. Another big shot here required from the skip, Aileen Neilson. Is she going to remove or push back that Chinese yellow stone? Let's have a look. She's aiming to. Does she just have it? Does she just have it? It's close. Oh, well, she's done well to get it into the center there. Big problem, of course, here. She wanted to have two. A lot will depend on whether Wang Haitao decides to try and take out the red in the center and leave his own, or whether he just wants to play a draw into the button. This is quite a crucial shot here. Will Great Britain get back into this at N3? Or will they just drift further off the pace? Hope you're enjoying it at home. It's really quite intense now. This is a big stone, N3. Final stone of N3 for the Chinese player, Wang Haitao. Is he happy with it? He's looking at taking out the center and he's saying, whoa, 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 what's going on? It's an out turner, and he's happy with that, but he won't be happy with the fact. Ooh, I think he was aiming to hit that on the nose and stay. But this is a really big opportunity here for Aileen Neilson to take two. He wanted it to be more on the nose than that, wanted it straighter. This is a big opportunity now.
You just see the hill.
Aileen Neilson, if she can just take that yellow and stick, then she can pick up two. Right, well, she's got the confidence. Now she's got to execute. This will be a really good 2 points. It's required.
Good.
A lot of this sport is about confidence. She's got to really, really look hard at this, get the weight perfect, accurate. Big, big stone here for Aileen Neilson. Drives it forward here at the end of N3. The final stone needs to touch yellow.
Come on!
It's coming on. It's coming on. It could be for two. And it is for two. Excellent play. Very good. Aileen Neilson brings Great Britain back within one at the end of N3. Wow. Yeah, it was nervy, it was edgy, but again, back in, and you can hear Aileen saying they will make mistakes. The mistake there, of course, that Wang Haitao made was that he didn't stick his own. If he hit it on the nose, it would have stayed, and that would have been a whole different problem. The union flags there, of course. It's really quite amazing how this sport of curling has developed its fan base. There's the score, 3-2 to China, but of course they do have the hammer now, so they'll have the final stone as we come up towards halfway. 8 ends to be played. And still the Russian crowd getting very excited about their prospects as well. And at sheet B at the moment, the gold medal match is on sheet A.
Front to the right a wee bit. Bay Moore.
Watch your back, dear. Whoa.
So, Angie Malone will be the first to go. Now, is this one going to be a guard set?
Okay, head.
Okay, 2-3.
Nice, follow through.
2-3, so that is going to be quite a short guard.
Looks a nice way, Angie.
16 draws. It's an in-turning shot. It's going to be quite proximate to, in fact, it's coming in. Yeah, that is right into the house.
Okay, just inside the house.
into the house and into the 8 foot white ring.
But I still, we need to get.
So, Zhu Chanjin. Is she going to play a guard or is she going to. Well, it looks like that's a pretty aggressive shot. And it looks like it's going to be more of a takeout there. Yes, it is. But is she going to take her own out as well? Not quite. It's gone way off to the side. Are they happy with that? I think they are.
2-3.
So the hit and roll works there for China. And for Hu Chanjin. Now, is this one going to be slightly to the right of the nose and come back over into the center? It's looking pretty approximate to the T line. Angie Malone sets it on its way. Let's have a look at where it's going. There it is.
She's
coming straight on in towards the a guard position into the center line.
That's better, dear.
Yeah.
That's where I had it in the charts.
Yeah.
I lost night game just off center line, but
yeah. Inside the wheel the track. They're ignoring that one out on the left side as they look at it. The Chinese stone. It might come into play later. Looking at picking up a split situation here on the T line. I hope you all understood that. A little bit of confusion as to what the captain requires. She wants it to have it just a little bit cleared again. So Chang Jiang obliges. Now, she can execute here. Zhu Chanjin.
Come on.
A really, really long stick.
Come
on. And she's not at all happy. She's not too happy. And this time she sets it out.
So
she's going to get rid of the guard. That could be. Could be. It looks like she's missed it. Oh dear. Certainly missed the guard, but has it gone all the way in? That's all right, isn't it? It's coming beautifully behind, into the 8 foot. Nicely behind the guard that was set by GBR.
Can you see it all, Jim? Can you see it all?
And you really couldn't tell from her reaction, could you? It looked as if she has really messed up there, but that's very good. She split it now, that was the idea.
Line.
Come on, Jim. Straight to the brush.
So, Jim Galt, you know. They've agreed.
Barrier, Jim. Line's good, Jim.
Strategy.
Barrier.
Now, it's a question of execution. 88% on his draws, but 44 on the takeouts, and that's been the big problem with GBR. The takeouts have not been so successful. There we go, another attempt to take out here, and this time it has been successful. And not quite a double touch, but at least got rid of one danger there around the guard. The crowd getting pretty excited. Russia battling for gold medal place here. Jim Galt shakes his head. Certainly the coverage has been quite superb, the television coverage, and you can see that the Got camera around at the side. They're all very intimately into this. There's nowhere to hide on this ice, I can tell you. Everything is checked and exposed. And if you make one small error, they'll find you out. The guard has been removed. Strategy once
more.
Zhang looking just a little bit anxious there, but this will be Jim's goal. There he is. Now, is this going to be a takeout? Coming away, but it looks as if it's going to be another attempt to put it guard to halfway, is it? It's come a little bit more than that. Yeah.
If he peels it again, we do have this to kind of heavy draw. You know, on but even if we're not short and make him go for it and it'll get jams.
You hear what she's saying. She's saying that the ambition will obviously be to another peel from Zhang Qian. The peel will be taking out that guard. Taking out the short red stone for Great Britain. The peel will come. Yeah, he's got it. Good work. Nice angle on it as well. No danger of interfering with the two that are holding there. China still have that slight advantage of the stone in the 12 foot, closest. Yeah, a little congratulatory high five there. Now, can you continue to keep putting up those guards? Gregor Yuan. Having a look at it, a little bit skewy to the side. What have we got? Angie Malone holding on tightly. The delivery, and now what's the result? Is he happy? Difficult to say from there. And again, it's going out wide. Is he just got it onto a guard position? It's going to be a bit short. Jim Galt says it's a good shot.
Yeah.
But
I mean, it was 4-5 was the call.
Was it going to be 3?
Yes. The yellow's line shot.
Right, okay.
Yeah, the yellow is line shot. You're absolutely right. Keep reminding you, China have got the hammer, so they will be the final stone. New way, sets it on its way. And is he going to attempt to get rid of that guard as well? The corner guard? Shout at that stone. No, it's going to be all the way into the house. Into the house. Up to the tee line and just beyond. That is an interesting one here. Three stones left for Great Britain. It will be Gregor Yuan again. I think he's happy. -6 degrees this ice. So the gloves are quite necessary. Jim Galt doesn't need them, does he? Galt from Lossiemouth. This is the vice skip, Gregor Yuan, and he will follow it on up because he knows that the next GBR will be Aileen Neilson. That's going to come in nicely inside. That's a good shot. That's a super shot. Great play. Well done, Gregor Yuan.
Jams, then we go for that one.
Very nicely played.
Come on, GB! Come on, GB!
you could hear there, Angie Malone getting involved. Well, this is interesting because although that yellow stone on the right is holding shot, it looks like the concentration of one Haitao is on all the cluster on the left. Liu Wei, the vice skipper, lining up. Really sorry, down the barrel of that stick. It's hard, and it is an outturner coming in towards that cluster of three that I mentioned before. Is he going to get round it? He just does. Oh, that's a great shot, but goes out himself. So at the moment, China just lying one. But at least he gets rid of one danger. He was hoping for both of them. Great reaction shots, aren't they? China with 40 minutes left. Great Britain with 38. It's not an issue. They'll have plenty of time to finish this. They're going to have a little bit of a break after this end. Just a couple of moments. Have to regroup. It's a big end, this. Great Britain are still in contention here, although China have certainly got the chance to take a two or even three shot lead into the second half. She doesn't like the takeouts. She likes the draws. That was a little bit of extra effort there, wasn't there? Is that an out turner?
Good line.
Yeah, we're good. Oh, we're
that's good.
Nice one, Aileen.
Will be attempt to take. Cool. And she does well. Yeah, well, we haven't seen many of them. So that really is a good shot. It's an in-turner, but it went wide out onto that right side, as you see.
Go TV! Go TV!
Yeah. There's still a lot of curling left to be played. But that's a good start. He's sitting two at the moment, I think. They have fun, don't they? Lots of confidential conversations going on between the four of them. They're all mic'd up. And again, this is an important shot for Wang Haitao. Have they got a bit of pressure on? Well, at least they've got the last stone. This is the first time we've seen the left-hander, Wang Haitao, come to the sheet here in this end four. And he goes out with a nice big swing through. Wow. He's got power. Has it got accuracy? It's got power. Does it have the... Yes, it does. Very good. Ooh, it needs to sit. Ooh, it's gone on a little bit. It's gone on a little bit. And that still means... That's very interesting. Because that means that Great Britain still has shot at the moment. Well, they expected to lose that one that was loose on the right, but this is a big bonus here at the moment for Great Britain. Given the option, of course, Wang Haitao may well take the single point. If it comes down towards the T-line, she just draws one in on the T-line, taking it right away from the danger zone. She doesn't want to lose that one, the red that's in shot at the moment.
Weird line
so
shot.
Take it right. Yeah, T-line shot will be the ideal. Then it's impossible for one Haitao to get right across. You give up one point here, they would have done well, I think.
And they'd get last stone.
They've got last stone.
They've got last stone.
Right up to it.
Aye.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking.
What's easy, Pep?
5-6.
Don't want to get too close.
Force them to play it anyway, Aileen.
Right,
okay,
there.
Yeah.
Just force them to play it anyway.
Certainly don't want to lose the opportunity to course, 1 point. Here we go. It's going to be a draw. It'll come in from the right side, I think. If she sees it. On to the blue. Oh, it's going to go further over than that. My gosh, it's coming. An out-turner coming close. Ooh, and that is going to be close. Yeah, well, they're sitting two at the moment, so that is going to be very interesting. That means it's gone down below the halfway line, the T line, so there's not going to be anything here that Wang Haitao can do except take out the one shot hold. And you never know, he might get unlucky and fall away, which means that it then... he's just basically going to go for a draw to the four. Draw to the four, pick up 1 point.
I guess it'll be
good.
Ho ho, that's good. Anywhere really inside the 12, the 8 will do it. He will be aiming at the 4, and this at the end of N4 will be the halfway stage. Is he going further over? I think he's going on. Wow. Wow, what could be happening here? This could be a disaster for oh my goodness me. That is 2 points. 2 points stolen by Great Britain. Cannot believe that. The end of N4, halfway stage, Great Britain against all the odds there. Pick up 2 against the Chinese hammer. Well, that really is extraordinary luck for Great Britain. They go into the halfway stage in the lead by 4 points to 3. Well, you probably heard me saying, where's he going? I just couldn't believe it. A draw to the center would have been enough. He was never going to surely get 2 out of it. Well, 2 at N3, 2 at N4. Great Britain in the lead, 4-3. That really is a huge surprise. Didn't expect that to come. It was a fairly simple draw into the center for Wang Haitao. He chose to go for something what is actually turned out to be crazily brave. Maybe he knows something more than I do. Russians playing for the gold right in front of the picture there, but in fact this graphic would suggest that 97% for Angie Malone. She's leading very well. 75% of the, they are in great position here to take advantage. It will be Russia to have the hammer for this one, but if it's the fifth hammer for China, sixth will then, if it goes normal way, sixth to Great Britain, seventh to China, and eighth, the last hammer could be to Great Britain. It's a big situation here for Great Britain in this bronze medal match. So the Chinese have really now got to pull themselves around. That was a big, big loss, that last end. Wang Haitao, who's the more burly of the two, is actually under a little bit of pressure here. The coach certainly trying to encourage, because that was a big, big issue. The draws, you can see how many more Great Britain are using over the Chinese in terms of the draws. The takeouts, twice as many from China. I think I mentioned that before. And look at the takeout percentage, 68% for China. Significantly more. Well, if that's the strategy, and you can see the score line there, 4-3, I don't suppose that I've got any way in which to complain.
It's when it gets started.
Angie!
Play!
No,
we're still going
a minute.
You can line up.
Get ready.
And again, it's all about time. You've got to, cannot afford to run out of time. So you heard Aileen Neilson said, we are up, we are leading off. They're in position, ready to deliver. Is it going to be to the house, or is it going to be a guard? The guard strategy has worked well, particularly out to the right, as she sees it. China have got the hammer still. They're the last stone players.
10 seconds.
Ten seconds before they can start. You can see five in the background. Great Britain have used up more time than China.
Ready?
Yep.
97% game accuracy since she came in to replace Bob McPherson halfway through the semi-final. It's going to come centre line and maybe just a little bit beyond it. And a guard there in the channel.
Just a wee bit tighter. I just need to make sure that line lined up properly right into the brush.
So now Zhu Jiangjin, the lead, the 23-year-old, needs now to get some confidence back in. So they've actually played very well, the three players prior to the skip. Wang Haitao's huge miss on four. This is going to go towards the center. In fact, it's going to go through again. My goodness, that is, it's got to be a strategy then, is it? I can't believe that. She wasn't attempting to peel that one, was she? I don't think she's too happy with that shot. It's all about confidence at the end of the day, isn't it? And the confidence of Great Britain is certainly building. Angie Malone again. She set one in. She's put one in a guard position, fairly central.
Good follow through, hold you.
4-5 suggests that it's going to be at the top of the house. Into the red 12-foot zone, maybe, just on the edge. There it comes in from the intern. In fact, she's going to put up another guard here, just past the hog line.
Challenge!
There you go. Two quite accurate guards, right?
In the You would think there was a radio mic, you just cut yourself there now and near wires or cables.
That's just an extra wee guard in case you get the back one.
An extra wee guard.
Well, it do there.
An extra little guard.
Oh, there!
Another strongish push through by Zhu Jiangjin. This time it does have the accuracy and it will take out one of the guards there. At least, if not both. One of them goes, but it still remains in contention there. That's interesting. Why would you not try to peel it right out?
4-5, Jim.
4-5. 4-5.
Well, again, yep. There's only four more ends to go in this bronze medal match. Great Britain holding 4-3.
Are you going to end up blocking the shot?
Quizzical
right.
Brow
Jim, just
of
move the throne
Aileen
to the right.
Neilson. Mother Goose, they call her. Well, she might lay the bronze egg if all goes to plan. Jim Gold is up. Coming in around the back. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh, I was just about to say that was going to be an absolute perfect setup there between, but it just caught the edge of that front guard.
You know what I mean? I didn't think I'd get past that one. Well, good access, but
yeah, need it. Was up. Are you going for that?
I was going for the tap. Yeah,
I didn't think I'd get past the yellow.
John, can you enjoy the hot chocolate?
I was fine on the
brush.
Somebody's got to get a little more aggressive in towards the house. We'll see whether or not Zhang Jiang's the man. Again, such long sticks, long poles that the Chinese are using. I wonder about the accuracy. They certainly got the strength with that distance. Has he got where he needs to be? Around the outside? And he's gone through the middle, that's good. But has it got the strength? It's coming through. It's coming through. Wow. I'm sure that he didn't mean to come through to the 12.
Come on, GB!
You can hear the shout, come on, GB.
Line's good, Jim.
But, interesting. Now, we're going to see, again, Jim Galt hitting it round, starting it way left, and coming even further round. He calls it a lot of ice, but that is coming around now as he got through the gap he has. And it's on its way towards the edge. Not quite, but hey, there's a big, big guard there, isn't there? Look at those guards. Four in a row.
12, like, there'll be a lead on the deck back here. No, I think it's on the 12.
Where is it?
Back here.
Jim Galt thinks he's actually touching. I don't believe it is. I don't believe it is. There's a lot stopping it right here, so we could be getting some promotions or attempt to peel here, and we'll see. Wang Haitao would have put his disappointment from the last end behind him, and now he's got to concentrate on taking advantage of this hammer. Zhang Jiang with his final stone of end five. Looked like that had some outturn on it. I'm not absolutely certain. But, no. Is he happy? Yeah, it's an in-turning shot, actually. He's got through the gap, but does it have enough on it? Ooh, just a little touch there, and he's actually touched the promoted, that Jim Galt stone into the house. Again, more disappointment for China. It really is another little moment of disappointment for China. I love it. Isn't that great? You see that moment when Liu Wei is saying, come on, go to the right a little bit more. Couple of big stones here for Gregor Yuan now.
Do you like the run back line?
I can see this in as well.
I just can't get it at that in behind there.
This line then.
Yeah?
There's potential for promoting. They're pushing their own stone forward.
But you're gone.
Or is he going to try to take out that yellow that's
nine.
Sitting
from here
in guard?
Noise, Gregor.
I think he was what, shifted
on the nose.
Just
that's what she wants to do. he's on, a character, you can tell. Gregor Ewan. Jim Galt joining in the fun. He's playing, being played in a great atmosphere. Lots of fun expected. Away it goes from Gregor Ewan. Is he going to have it on the nose? He needs power. He's going to try to clear this yellow one at the head. Does he have it in position? It might come a little bit too far. He does. Oh dear. Well, he's the kiss and the run is inside, and in fact he's not quite holding shot. The one at the bottom is holding shot, but the attempt was to push it forward. Perhaps he was even trying to promote his own stone further forward, but it certainly didn't just quite work
keep
out.
Try and keep them duty at one.
Yeah, I know.
It's all about angles here, isn't it? From that lead stone. Is he going to use it and promote? Or is he just going to draw in towards the centre?
八九
Liu Wei, the vice skip. Yeah, that looks like he might be trying to promote his own in towards the blue. Let's see if we can get into the 4 foot zone. It looks very much like that to me. Has he got through it? Ooh, yes, he has. But, I got a feeling that he was probably looking to try and push his own through. This is interesting. They sit two at the moment, China. The big, big ambition of Aileen Neilson will be to restrict China to 1 point here. That would be a huge achievement.
Six goods, Gregor.
Gregor Ewan will play it. And six is about button strength for the draw. Is he happy? Hard to say. Jim Galt doesn't tell us anything behind him either. Let's have a look at this. It's definitely going to promote something. Which one? Ooh, and that could be three now, I think. It is sitting three at the moment. China. Still two stones remaining for Aileen Neilson, of course. So it's not all lost yet. But if that draw comes into the blue from Wang Haitao, it could put a lot of pressure on. The Russian crowd getting pretty excited. They are really supporting their team in the gold medal match, but this is the bronze at the moment. And just look at them all coming up and having a look out here. There's a lot of anxiety, furrowed brows. Yeah, it's a conference. Is it a timeout? Couldn't be a timeout, but a loud one. The clock's still ticking, so it is not a timeout at the minute. Liu Wei's final stone. They've had their little family meeting. Important is for China. They need to really take advantage of this situation. He's cleaned off the bottom of the stone as Liu Wei. There you go. It's an important, big, big shot this. Setting up for more than 1 point. Stopwatch on. firing line has been picked and out it goes. Yeah. To say from that face whether or not he's happy with it. It's a outturning draw. Is it going to just drop? Oh dear, what's going on here? It just kisses, and it's another guard. There's not going to be much through there, but there's certainly opportunities for Aileen Neilson to promote here.
Yeah,
a really good hard look at it.
It's right in the very bottom. Cheers.
Can I do anything?
Jim?
Oh, I just need to get morphine, so.
Jim?
Huh?
One up. Let's have a look at this.
I think Gregor was off the bloody. What? Cheers. What's happened?
Don't know quite
Gregor took a technical timeout to take some medicine.
Oh, right.
You can hold the brush. You want to go back down and be ready to buddy. I'm just going to go for a tap up in this gym, okay?
That's really. Gregor Ewan is taking some medicine here.
If you go into the head, I'll have a wee look.
Aye.
So, Jim, go and take the brush. Technical timeout is called. That is why we have an official in here. So.
Let me buy
you and Gregor, is he back in shape now?
Middle of the 8, Jay Gregor. Tap up on the centre line.
All right, okay.
Middle of the 8.
Well, he was only missing for a short time. I thought he had some illness there, but he was just to take some medicine. He's now back in motion, and the official will disappear into the background.
5, 6. Do you want this side?
Exciting times here.
J.
Coming towards the end of N5.
Come on, Aileen.
Cheers.
Jim Galtz comes back to his position. On the side. And Angie Malone will do her.
Like this way, Gregor.
Do her business to hold the chair. It's all getting pretty crowded in there. Just about 30 minutes left, so there's plenty of time for these teams.
Line's good, Aileen.
They can really think. Angie was saying that the lineup is good with the chair. So now, delivery is the important thing. Don't leave it short. Got to get it inside, put a bit of pressure on, get it around the back of the guard, maybe. It is coming at good pace towards. Yeah, through it goes and a little promotion, and that's very nicely played. Good work there, and there's also a guard there, which is really putting a bit of pressure on. Great work from Aileen Neilson. Let's have a look at this promotion. Nicely played around the front guard. Nice, it's really a very, very good shot there, just off the right of the nose. And now, there's got to be perhaps some attempt of a takeout, maybe a double takeout. Lots of opportunities here for Wah Hai Tao. Certainly, he won't be thinking back to the last end, when he made a real mess of the final shot. Got two chances here. Liu Wei concentrating with the brush. And listen to the crowd again. They're pretty excited at what's going on in the gold medal match. I can't tell you. Here in the bronze medal match, it's 4-3 to Great Britain. N5, a hammer with China. They got the last stone. And immediately there's going to be an attempt to take out here by Wang Haitao. He's put one down very, very strongly. Could it be a single or a double takeout? Let's have a look at it. It's coming through. That's the single. There's the double. And he does really well. That's a very, very impressive hit. Wow. Good stuff. He's happy with that. Wang Haitao. That's the inter. Well, actually, it's an out turner. He's a left-hander, of course, but that is very good play. Excellent. Oh, and they the brush comes off the end of the handle. I think he was pretty excited by that, wasn't he? Liu Wei. And of course, that was a pretty exciting moment from Su Shanqing beside her skip. Yeah, he lost the brush. Right, this is the final stone now of this end five. It's a big one. They all are, I guess. Aileen Neilson setting herself up. Angie comes in to anchor the chair. No fuss, push away. Got to get this draw in towards the danger area, right around the blue mark would be nice. It's an in-turner. Is it going to be promoting or is it going to go all the way? It's going to be promoting and it's getting there, but is it a little bit too? No, it's okay. That's a good shot, and in fact, that is an excellent shot because that is holding shot at the moment. Well, that is final blow there, and this is another big challenge for Wang Haitao. It looks like if he can get rid of that, if he can get rid of the one that's sitting there in the blue, then China could pick up 3 points. It's certainly a possibility that China picks up three at this end and could sit at 6-4 at the end of this one. Liu Wei coming back. Yeah, this is a big discussion here. They need now to get rid of that blue, of the red that's inside the blue circle, inside the 4 foot. Not easy. Final stone of the fifth end. And the challenge is for Wang Haitao to get rid of that red stone of Great Britain that sits in the blue 4 foot. If they do that, they could actually, it looks like they might even pick up four if they get rid of it. They certainly have got two sitting in reserve, three potentially. And if this yellow one does its business, it's either three or four. Ah, this is really exciting stuff. N5 about to be complete. The last stone with Wang Haitao. It's on its way. Can it now do the business and get rid of Aileen Neilson's stone in the blue area? Shouting at the stone, will it help? It's on its way. It's on its way. Oh, and it's not going to do anything there. And it points its stone. Well, that's very, very good for Great Britain. Disappointing for China. That's two in a row for Wang Haitao. He's not made it. Didn't get round the guards. So yet another point to Great Britain. They pick up to 5-3 at the end of the fifth end. Well, it is really an extraordinary change around. They started out with 3 points to China. They took one in the first, they took two in the second, and then they've fallen apart. They've lost 2-2 and 1. So 5-3 in favor of Great Britain. A steal like that is very impressive. But don't forget, that means, of course, that China potentially have the final end hammer. But we'll see. It's all panning out very nicely for Great Britain right at this moment. Nerve-wracking stuff here at the medals challenge, you might say. Well, she's done really well as Angie Malone in this matchup. Got great accuracy record. And she's not afraid to put them short into guard positions, and the guards really helped in that particular scenario. Jim Galt encouraging, says it's all yours, fire away.
That's better, eh?
That's about right, he says. It's on its in-turning way towards the centre line. It'll come up short of the house, and it'll be a good guard.
Good
Ange! That's fine, Angie.
That's exactly where she put the last one.
Go GB!
Encouraging the crowd. Angie Malone from Gurvan.
Conventional plunge.
Yep. And even if it comes up a tight three.
Well, in fact, she was educated in Ayr on the west side of Scotland. So Janjin gets away. She was a para swimmer at one time. She competed in para swimming. One time finished fourth in the national games for athletes with an impairment. She's going to see this one puck through again, is she? I can't believe this. It is. It's coming through the back. Not quite. Huh. Stays in the 12.
4-5.
She calls her hero, the Chinese badminton player Lin Dan. Well, I can tell you, he is something very, very special. You want a hero, he's the one. Multi-Olympic champion.
Turn your chair to left, Ange. Bit more yet.
Yeah.
Bit more.
Yep, yep.
Now, what's in store here for Angie Malone? Is she going to play another one short to guard? She'll go and chase the one that's there. Well, that's a little bit stronger. Stronger than we've seen. Let's see where it ends up. It's going to guard again. It's going to be on the middle. There you go. Double. Needed a bit more weight, she says. But,
that more weight, yeah.
No, phone called a 4-5. I did my fingers.
For a 4-5.
Have you ever needed me a real ear in here?
I've just been doing that.
Well, how about you, Emma? Well, how about you,
Well, it's 2 points the difference. 5-3 to Great Britain at the moment. Three ends to go. All to play
for.
The evolving intricacies of curling. And wheelchair curling in particular. Away it goes from Zhu Changjin. Is she going to get rid of the center guard? She's missing that. Right through to set up her own short guard there. You can see it's all getting very exciting. Gregor Ewan clapping his hands, saying, yeah, okay, we're okay at the moment. There's a lot of big atmosphere around this fabulous ice cube curling centre. On the coastal cluster, Paralympic Winter Games coming towards a conclusion. And the atmosphere has been fantastic. This is an out-turner, so coming around from right to left as he sees it, and it's not even gone up to the hog line. So, bye-bye, Mr. Stone. Bit of a waste there from Jim Gulf. Much too much ice there to play with. Haitao giving his instruction. Champion. 58% takeout, 44% draw. What have we got on the cards here? Is he going to take out those? I think he goes for peel shots here. This looks like it could be a peel on those two center guards. Going to have the angle on them. Oh, he's missed that. Gone around and in towards the 4 foot. Good shot. Nice shot.
Charmel.
Yeah, very good. Excellent. So he didn't have that ambition to try and get rid of the guards, the middle guards. Be happy with that and see if they can build up from here. Jim Gaunt failed to make the hog line before, that big red line that suggested that the suggested that he wasn't strong enough to get it into play. Short. He'll be fired up for this one. This is definitely going to go past the hog line. To be in days of yore, of course, it was to do with the pigs that were kept around the lakes, and now it's past the hog and it's in towards, it's gone around the second one, and this will take it out. That's beautifully played. Nicely played there by Jim Gaunt. Good gulp. Very good. So, Benji Malone gets the crowd going again. Exciting, isn't it? Around there, just past that Chinese guard. So the ambition is quite clear for the Chinese. They've got to get rid of that annoying little red stone in the blue circle. Did a good job last time to Chang Chiam around the outside of the guards. Now the attempt will be perhaps to take Jim Gault's stone away and replace it with his own. Let's have a look what is happening here. It's coming in at speed. Where's Jim Stone? He's missed it. Ooh, in fact, he was lucky not to take his own out there. So, it's getting to the stage now, although China are still very much in this match. A couple of errors and it could make the balance of power change. Gault failed with his first attempt to cross the hog line. With the second, he's made a really good shot that's put pressure on now. And he's got a little bit of hiding potential, you can see. And in fact, it's being hidden by the Chinese guard right in front. Developing into a very interesting end, this. Lots of possibilities, lots of variety of attack. That's the way. He's going to have an in-turning shot here. It'll come from left to right as he sees it. It's a draw, and it's going to attempt. Sit there with.
Nice shot.
Yeah, that's a good shot. It's protecting. Protecting, it might not be quite enough to protect there, you can see. That's exposed just a little bit on the blue.
Can you see it?
Just a little bit. The thing is, unless he hits it right in the perfect position, it's going to be difficult to clear it out. He might even promote it onto his own stone. So this is going to be tough for Liu Wei. Not easy. Okay, getting it right down to the full extent of this long, long stick. Liu Wei with the first of his N6 shots. Does it have the accuracy? It's tough when it's at that distance and you haven't got your hand on it. There's one gone. Well, that's a double takeout, but it's the takeout of a peel of a guard.
You see any of it?
Come on,
so there?
This is going to be very interesting now for the next stone to come in from Gregor Yuan. This is going to be, surely it's going to be a draw in towards the blue. The 4 foot. There's the brush. And Aileen. The instruction is given. The challenge is laid out, and here it comes. Again, is it an out turner?
Oh, can I get up here?
It certainly is, and it's making its way.
Oh, bouncing,
really
bouncing,
it's really catching that draw, is. Isn't it?
Oh, it's crying. Yeah. That's right.
Sorry.
It's short. Short, and it certainly hasn't done anything to stop the view of Wang Haitao.
Season.
I can't believe that he didn't.
If it's going
to
over-curl like that,
there.
We're going to have to come out of the
building. Then up again, that's all they can do, I think.
They has to.
Yeah.
Actually, this is Liu Wei still. He's got one more shot. The instruction is given.
I told him very young.
Liu Wei
would
be looking at shifting some red rock here. Yeah, it's gone with a whole bunch of strength there. This is a peel. He obviously enjoys the physical side of it. Here it comes. One. Okay. No, one has gone.
他就要打那边了，你说？其实那壶不应该往里旋，你知道吗？就应该往下面走了，就不走了。Even though we've been outside it。So well, you want the brush? Yeah, where do you want? Really disappointed.
He was attempting a double take out there. It didn't happen.
Yeah.
Are we geared?
Erika Ewan has come down to the other end to take over the skip's roll to hold the broom, the brush, where he thinks she should be aiming. Jim Galt sitting there.
Line's good.
Motionless,
line's good.
Concentrating. Line. Looking pretty good at the moment, but is it going to? No, it's just going to. Well, that is interesting. It's interesting because it's got a. It's actually created a perfect guard. Yeah, it's split, but it's actually provided a bigger challenge here for Wang Haitao. Wow, another bit of good fortune. It is a piece of good fortune, isn't it? Let's set up some really good guards here. GB holding, holding point at the moment.
Mm.
So Wang Haitao coming back to take his first of two stones. They need to score here. Getting rid of that stone inside the blue at the moment is the number one ambition. Left-handed.
You
can bring it in. Getting all very, very excited here. There's going to be some action on granite on granite right here. China need to get some space and get some viewpoints through. Have they managed it? One. No, they haven't. That is really good fortune for Great Britain. There's a lot to think about there. Now, this is a really interesting one for Aileen Neilson. Is she going to draw one straight in? Is she going to try to promote, or is she just going to try and put a block in, a guard?
Middle of the 12.
Go for G, Aileen.
1-2.
Yeah.
G.
Yeah.
Mm. Well, you can see where the brush is. It's in the middle of the 12.
Come on, Aileen.
Mark.
Come on, baby.
Jim Galt, he's got some wonderful expressions, and obviously, I really do enjoy this. Aileen Neilson getting set.
1-2.
6 almost complete. This is her final stone.
Mine's
good. One more to come from China. The draw could be big. Yeah, she knows how big this stone is. Huge pressure. It's on its way. Will it make the house? Has she decided to try and put a block in there? It's on its way, and it is an outturner on the way to the house. It's coming up short, is it? It is. The block is there, but that's not a problem. That is not a problem. The more blocks that are there, the harder it is to get through.
It's good. It's a very long one.
Yeah, through the gap is the possibility for Wang Haitao. Through the gap is the only real possibility. There's a big gamble at getting through the middle, isn't there? Wang Haitao, if he gets through that port, that will be an extraordinary shot, and it will deserve getting points. China down by 2 at the moment. Final stone of N6. It's a fascinating matchup. Big, big point for Wang Haitao. Got to get through the gap. Got to take out the Aileen Neilson Great Britain stone. Is he managing to do it? He's having a look at it, concentrating. Has it made it through the gap? No, that's one miss, but look at the second. Oh, it's a beauty. Oh, what a shameful China. What a big break for Great Britain. It has come through, and that promotion ultimately gives them yet another point. That is now a really big lead for Great Britain.
What are we doing?
Great effort.
What are we doing?
Stealing. Guard.
Stealing.
Don't you
win. Same again.
Don't you win. 你选不是，你听我说，你选的比你好，他打的话，他用不着力量，就十秒多。
Well, you wonder who the captain is, don't you? Zhu Changqin is really giving it something. So there is the score at 6-3, and China at the end of N6 have still got the hammer, because it was another steal from Great Britain. 6-3, you cannot believe that. Started out first end, first point to China. Second end was 2 more points to China, so that was 3-0. And since then, it's all been Great Britain in 3, 4, 5, and 6 ends. 2 more to go. Angie Malone sits there confidently at the moment, 3 points in the lead. This for the bronze medal.
That's a good answer.
Same as before, past the center line and up for a middle guard. It's all serious stuff here now. It's 3 points the difference. And of course, we have seen 7 points picked up by Russia in the semi-final against Great Britain. So it's not all finished yet by any stretch. Certainly you'd have to favor Great Britain in this bronze medal match at the moment. Zhu Changqin shouting at the stone to come in and make the house. It's an obedient stone for Zhu Changqin. on the shoulder. Yeah, she's really done well.
Straight
this
up,
has been a
Angie.
Come on, Ange.
Yeah.
Big, big change
straight
of good fortune here for Great Britain.
Front
taking
to the
advantage
left.
Of their
left, left.
Yeah, left.
Front to
taking
left.
Advantage
a bit,
of their good fortune, but also played much, much
the
better.
Left.
In this match. Kim Galt not happy with the positioning of Angie Malone's chair. They do have fun, don't they? A little moment, I told you to go left. Move out the road. Now, again, a Scottish expression, just
good.
Move out the way a little bit. Now we go.
Come on,
Ange.
Okay, Ange. Oh. Straight to the brush. Looks good to me, Ange.
Straight to the brush was
come
the
on,
instruction,
Ange.
As she managed to do that.
Come on! Come on!
Oh, well, essentially, it worked out better than they'd expected. There's a couple of good things that's happened there. That the roll from the tap has come into a good position. In fact, that shot here at the moment for Great Britain. But there's also another, a guard set up as well. Fascinating. Maybe a little tipple of whiskey there, Angie, is it? So, Zhu Chanqin, again, her second shot, needs to do something here. Has she taken it out? No, she's just attempting to put it into the center. Nicely played, yeah. A little bit strong, but that's okay. Past the key. At least they've taken back the initiative here now. Just about 16 minutes left on each of the clocks, you can see above the head of Wang Haitao. Now Jim Galt, the character who was really, really fortunate to be here, took the place of Tim Killen, who fell ill just before they flew out. He's had a wonderful time here, and if he takes home a bronze, well, just the icing on a big cake. This is an attempt to take out, and he oh, and he's taken his own out as well. Well, it's not as bad as it the first look. Galt at least has got rid of that.
Short, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's hard work, isn't it, Jim?
If he's smart, he'll need to protect that because he's doing his too.
Little discussion between the skip and the vice skip, Rego and Aileen. They're all having a little chat there. Enjoying the conference, and of course, the loads of possibilities. So many different ways of playing this sport. The first time that China have been in a Paralympic Winter Games, so haven't they done well? Getting to the final stages. Great Britain finished seventh in the 2010 Paralympic Winter Games in Vancouver. And entered the 2006 Games in Turin as favourites and reached the final against Canada after finishing second in the round robin stage, beating Sweden in the semi-final. The score at 6-3 to Canada after seven ends. British skip Frank Duffy aimed to move Canada's stones and score four of his own for his team, but missed the routine shot and eventually lost out. In the end, the game ended 7-4 to Canada. It's very small margins that make the difference in this sport. China are certainly not out of it, although they're down by three at the moment.
在后面都是垫儿，咱还落后那么多分。
52% both sides of the equation there.
Straight to the brush.
Jim and his opposite
just
man.
Just the nine.
Chang Qian. So Jim goes again, sets it on its ways, fired it out from right to left.
Come
so that'll be an out turner.
Come on!
Oh, and in fact, it is an in turner. I do beg your pardon, but that's an attempt to take out. Good shot. Good shot. Excellent work. A hit, a take out, and a roll to the button.
Hey, good shot, Jim.
Yeah. You've got to be very, very clever with those chairs, haven't you? You could be interfering with a lot of action there. It's difficult to put it back if you get hit. China still got the hammer, but they're not able to take advantage to it. Here's Chang Qian. It's his final stone, and it's going to be a takeout attempt. It's coming through the center and makes it nicely. Well, he could have actually, he would have preferred that one to not take that promotion.
If you like it from the minus,
no, 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 I'm happy with that one.
Take out the his own yellow.
No, it's hit now.
Over a bit, Ange. Over a bit.
Touching the line.
Gregor Ewan giving instructions to Angie Malone about anchoring behind. He needs it in the absolutely right position. He feels comfortable there now.
Stop jumping so much up that end. I'll get down here quicker.
That ice okay?
Yep.
The ice okay instruction is, you know, is it too much? Is it far enough out? Right. Heavy breathing here required and good control. Has he got?
Yeah. Come on.
Jim Galt giving it instructions, and is it obeying? It is. Just the wrong side, actually. Could have done with a little bit more left on that. Not bad.
There's
still three reds in contention.
You're picking hedges up there sometimes. Yes.
Jim.
Believe me, they are the best of friends.
You're 站不上了，先打吧。我觉得先打。那你站一个，威哥，加油。Well,
I hope you're enjoying it, because I certainly am. It's a fascinating matchup. This is for the bronze medal. Both teams very well matched. There's a lot of ambition here, and this, the first stone of Liu Wei. Took up curling in 2007 in Harbin, and he wants it to slow down a little bit. He feels it's going a bit strong here. No brushing. Ooh, and it's frozen there, and that's good. Well done. Just that little touch inside, but that's, he was giving it instructions to slow down, and it's okay. Look at this, lovely reaction. How dare you go so fast.
Same way. We bit that way.
It's a big one here.
We bit that way.
Look at the difference. Gregor Ewan. 33% in terms of game accuracy. Well, you weigh at 77. Need to have something going for you here then, don't we? The vice skipper. Again, the big breath before the launch. The delivery now. And he's looking for yellow right here now. He needs to actually clear something out. We haven't seen much takeout by this Great Britain team, but they need to do it right here. It's on its way. Does it have the accuracy? Yes, it does. Good play. Excellent shot. That is a very good shot. And if you'd believe the statistics before this, you'd have not given him much chance of delivering that shot. That was very good. Well played. So after all that effort, Wang Haitao's now looking at a shot held by Great Britain. Now the takeout here, potentially, from the UA. Has he got it? Has he got it? Let's have a look. It certainly looks as if his aiming got it on the nose here. Beautiful. Well played. Oh, in fact, takes out the other red. So, Aileen Neilson needs to look up and just see what her options are. That's a very, very good shot. Right on the nose, takes out two. Double takeout there for Liu Wei. Well, you can only guess at what's happening on the other sheet, because the Russian home crowd are very, very excited. It's N7 at the moment. If China pick up one or two, it will go to the final end with Great Britain with the hammer and the final stone. So it is looking very interesting. Just listen to the crowd there. Surely something has happened very positively for Russia. They are playing Canada. And the applause continuing, so I'm sure it's going to be pretty difficult for these two teams to keep concentration with all the noise going on. Three to Great Britain at the moment, and this the penultimate shot for Aileen Neilson. Gets it away, sits there. Concentration aplenty there as it makes its way, and it'll certainly get into the danger zone, but is she just about taking it? That was close. Now that is interesting, because that gives Wang Haitao a real interesting problem. Is he going to try and take out that one on the left, or is he going to try to fill the center? They're holding two at the moment. China. Could it still put them behind? They need to pick up three, really, to put huge pressure on the Great Britain team. As I said, difficult for Liu Wei to keep his concentration. He's looking out over his shoulder as well. Wang Haitao sets himself for this one. Another big shot. It's his first one of the seventh end. Eight ends altogether. Is he happy with this? Does it have the takeout potential? Or is he just going to put it in towards the 4 foot mark? It's on its way, but it's going to hold up a little bit short there. No. Well, he's going to try to block it. It's a kind of guard in at the 12 foot. Still loads of combination opportunities here for Aileen Neilson. I think they sit three at the moment, China, but let's have a look over the top in a moment. Fascinating.
Just need to draw right onto those.
Come on, Aileen.
What are we going to see here? Aileen Neilson, 73%. That is a really, really good stat, isn't it? Wang Haitao, we've seen he's been off. He's been off his normal fabulous accuracy. And that's made the big difference here. He's missed a couple of real ends. That's made Great Britain, given them the opportunity to steal. Last stone here for Aileen Neilson. It's on its way. It needs to do some damage here, I believe, to those yellow stones that probably sit three at the minute. She turns away. It's on its way in towards the house. Coming on to the house, but does it have enough? Does it have enough? It does. That's a really good shot. Now, that really is a fascinating one, because if Wang Haitao does not get inside that, or if he tries to play it, he could well knock a couple of his own out the way as well. This is very interesting. The best he can hope for, probably, absolute best, would be three. Get rid of the red and sit for three. It's very unlikely for that to happen, though, isn't it? Because if he touches, the red, it's going to take one of his own out. This is a really good opportunity for Great Britain here. Final stone. End seven. It's a do or die here for China. You have to believe it. They could pick up three. That's the best scenario. Here it goes. Wang Haitao hasn't played very well in this match so far. Is this going to be redemption time? He's talking to the stone. Does it have enough, or is it the wrong side? Let's have a look. Oh, it is the wrong side. And that is a brilliant, brilliant result for Great Britain. Aileen Neilson's stone ends up with another steal. That's extraordinary. 7-3 now in favor of Great Britain. And that is just a really, really big, big moment for Great Britain. And they are on their way to a bronze medal here. Tremendous tension in the air. At Great Britain looking solid here with one end to go. You hear what Gregor Ewan is saying there, 9:15 on the clock. It's just made really for a lot of tension here. One end to go, they've really got to get through. But just look at that stat, that's extraordinary, isn't it? China take the first two, that was 3-0 up after two. Since then, it's all been steal time. Well, the other match is finished, and judging by the sound, I'm not going to let the cat out of the bag to tell you what the score was, but certainly this is the only match in town right now. Great Britain, 7-3 over China, final end to come.
Everything you've got.
Is she going to go through? It feels like she might have gone through.
Come on, get through.
Yeah, that was the ambition. She's not going to allow, surely, has it gone through? Oh man, it just might stay. Oh, it is caught the edge. It is on the edge.
Wow. Did a bungee forward?
Didn't want to have anything giving the Chinese any attempt to use the Great Britain stones. And immediately, very, very fast, it's all Chanjin. Po-faced and really disappointed with the situation at the moment. But she's bringing this one up pretty close to the house. Dropping it in just a little short.
Whoa!
Maybe rushing it a little bit, but...
What?
Well...
Come on!
I cannot believe how many steals that Great Britain have managed since the second end.
Straight through.
Straight through is the ambition, and it's not as easy as it sounds.
Straight through.
Yeah.
20.
Come on, Angie, straight through.
Kilo stones. And they take a bit of effort to push through the house. There it goes. Yeah, oh, easily. That's better. That'll certainly be through now.
Yeah.
Happy with that. So her day is done, Angie Malone. That would certainly be my estimation, and she'll get a roll off that one and away. That's what she, that was the ambition. That was the ambition, to get both through. All the luck has gone with Great Britain, no doubt at all.
Need to reset or re-overthink it, Aileen. And they'll just got me another pull-out and pull-in again.
They are in absolutely A1 position at the moment, Great Britain. They've had their elements of luck. Wang Haitao, the skip of China, has not played to his potential. But, well, that's not going to make the mark. The hog line. And that is out. So it's all now a question of when, I believe. I don't think China will resign before. Maybe they will. I don't know. But before the end of the actual match, we'll see.
Straight to the brush.
Looking very rueful in the background, aren't they, the Chinese? Oh, Jim Galt comes up. Is he going
to
go through?
Jump to the side.
Tries a little bit of extra speed on this one, but this will go straight through. He doesn't want it to be stopped. Straight through. You might think this is a little bit pointless and aimless. It's certainly not aimless. In fact, it needs to be accurate, especially when you've got guards in the way. It's going to be very tough for Wang Haitao to get back into this one. So let's see whether Zhang Jiang can get one in the score circles, the house. In fact, it's not going to be that far up, is it? There's another guard here. Center guard. A little bit of peel weight for this one, I'm sure.
Go on, Jim.
From Jim Galt.
Straight to the brush.
Hold my chair, feet on.
Center line.
Peel nine.
Peel weight for sure.
Line's good.
Take your time, make it count.
You heard right,
Gregor Ewan said, take your time, make it count. If he makes a good one here, he'll be pretty happy with the fact that he's made such an impact on this tournament. And that is a good peel weight. It's one gone. Very good. So Jim has done his bit, and having replaced Tom Killen right at the last moment, he'll be delighted. He could well be getting a medal around his neck very shortly. Judging by the sounds all around at the moment, the Russian's pretty excited. Still contributing to the atmosphere of this wonderful Paralympic Winter Games. It has been quite remarkable here in Sochi. We've had a fantastic time, seeing some superb competition, great camaraderie, and another stone is put into guard position in the center.
Go over way. If you go that way, you might jump.
Do it this way. It's to be a nine.
Yeah.
Again, it's Ewan.
Come on, Gregor.
Gregor Ewan will take this opportunity to try and peel another one. Ultimately defensive, there doesn't need to be anything else but that. Is it accurate enough? Yeah, it looks like Angie Malone thinks it's all right. And it's gone. Taking one through. And the promotion there, and they're all getting very excited, aren't they? They were so, so upset earlier when they were trounced by Russia. But it's all smiles at the moment after this situation has resolved, with China up against the wall. I didn't mean anything other than they're finding a real block here. Shot there from Liu Wei on its way to the house. Just creeps, well, almost creeps past. Still on the 12 foot, but now there's going to be another big attempt for Great Britain to perhaps move that one out of the way as well. Three stones left on each side. Great Britain, home and hosed here. Nothing that the Chinese can do. So Gregor Yuan finishes his tournament right here. And he follows it through. It's an in-turner, and he's done it. Good shot. And not only that, he's gone in behind another block guard, so that's in great position. Wow, they have taken advantage of every opportunity, Great Britain. Done really well, and isn't that nice? That's it, they have conceded. I don't think we're going to get any more stones, are we? No, that's it, that's it. And after taking the first two ends, one and then two, it's all been Great Britain, and they celebrate in style. Unfortunate there for Wang Haitao, he didn't play his best, but the Great Britain crowd here are delighted with the bronze medal they've just achieved here in the Paralympic Winter Games in Sochi. It's all great camaraderie, and for the first time China have been in the Paralympic Winter Games. And you can see what it means to Gregor Yuan and his team. It has been a tough old road, but they've just done enough to edge out China and take the bronze. You said you wouldn't cry. You brought me tears. Can't be happy and cry so much. Of course you can, of course you can.
Well done, buddy. We're taking a hit out of
bronze medal to Great Britain and to Aileen Neilson, the skip of the Great Britain team. The supporters have been here in force, the flags are out, and the celebrations will start. It's a podium finish for the Great Britain team. Aileen Neilson, Gregor Yuan, Jim Galt, and of course Bob McPherson, the alternate.
Thank you very much.
Thanks everybody for your support.
7-3 to Great Britain in the bronze medal match. It was a great achievement in the end. They took advantage of some pretty poor play from Wang Haitao, but that was huge in the end. Great, great success for Great Britain, and a bronze medal.
Oh, we've only gonna just got a medal. Yes, told you, babe, we'd be here with a medal. Done it, Christine.
The alternate, Bob McPherson on the left, placed in the semi-final, but this is now just beginning to hit home what they've achieved. Third place in the Paralympic Winter Games in Sochi. There are the game stats. 67% on the draws, more or less the same. Takeout 54, win 43. Great Britain were never, ever going to be leading in that, but all round they've taken advantage and they stole like real thieves throughout that whole match.
This is for everybody back in Lossy Mouth.
Lossy Mouth, he says. And certainly it's been a fabulous, fabulous evening here for the team from Great Britain. The Ice Cube Curling Centre. Finished seventh in 2010 in the Paralympic Winter Games in Vancouver. They were second in Turin. I have to say, this is actually a very impressive performance. The Russians have enjoyed themselves, there's no doubt at all about that. First time in the Games. The Chinese also the first time in the Paralympic Winter Games. And we will be getting the prize presentations in a while.